What is up, everyone? It's me, Dan, again, and I want to go in depth. I don't know if free agency has started yet, but I tiptoe it and get to the facts, really. Because honestly, free agency is coming up soon. It's a weird time, right? And there could be some potential moves that the Heat might need to make. So I kind of listed it down to at least three or four candidates who could possibly leave. And let's just get to it. Frankly, some of you are gonna probably hate some of the picks I make, some maybe not. But again, I could be wrong on this, and I'm hope I'm wrong, because I don't want this to be true. And I like some of the guys, but let's just keep it to this minimum and not cause an outbreak, really. Okay, so first of all, the first obvious Heat player I kind of expect to go is UD. Yes, I know we've all been saying that ever since, he's been given a limited role in his career, especially as of now. The dude hasn't played anymore, and I'm not saying he should retire, but it's possible that this could be the last we see of UD, maybe, if he wants to come back another season and sign another 1 year contract. Kudos to him. Frankly, I would not be disappointed. I would be rather honored because like he said, he wants to help these young guys. He wants the young core to get to the highest peak they can get and get back to the finals. And he wants that. He wants to do that. I know earlier he said that if he wanted to retire, he wanted to make sure that the young guys, the young bloods, were finals material, and they are. And they've shown that they can get back to the finals, and they can show it again. But I'm getting off topic. But UD, been with this team for 17 or 18, 17 years now, since Wade was here, and he's done so much for the community. I would hate to see him go, but I would understand if he leaves because he's not wasting a spot. He's not wasting, an important player. Or someone who could help us on off the bench, some more supporting cast, really. That's kind of what we need. So, but hey, like I said before, kudos to UD if he wants to stay for one more year at least and get another shot at that ring. Okay, second player I kind of expect. This one's not really a top consideration. This is more of a on a, this one's more of an honoree, but that would be Kelly Olynyk. Now, Kelly Olynyk, you asked me, whoa, why do you think he'll leave? Well, I don't know. For some reason, I have a feeling that he might. Well, I know he's probably going to opt in to his contract because, he was. I forgot how much they paid him, but I know they gave him kind of a big contract when he first joined the Heat back in 2017. And don't get me wrong, like I said, love Kelly Olynyk. I love me some KO, but he's kind of slowed down a little bit in the finals. And towards the deeper into the playoff run. Sure, during the bubble, he lit it up. He lit up so much. And that got me excited for him. Kelly Olynyk was great. But honestly, with contract disputes coming up, I feel like they're gonna try to find another asset. And it depends that if they get another big or rebounder, then I can possibly see them trading Kelly Olynyk. That couldn't be true, but it's a maybe. It is frankly a maybe. It's a hole, really. Another big candidate that I could see leave the Heat is Jay Crowder. Now, I know what you're all thinking. Why Jay Crowder, you ask? And not to hate on Jay Crowder. I can, to be honest, I can possibly see him coming back for the Heat next year. I can possibly see Pat Riley and Mickey Arison try to figure out a deal with him. But the only reason I kind of say that he might leave the team is because he's been everywhere, guys. He's been everywhere on the team. I know that doesn't make any excuses, but the guy literally jumps to every team, and they've gotten rid of him for a reason, the other teams, which is disrespectful, but. And of course, I noticed in the finals or later in the finals where his shot making was just off the hook. He was struggling. I don't know what it was, but it was just, we needed him desperately to light it up with the Lakers. And the three ball, even when he's wide open, miss, 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 miss. It's inconsistent. Like, he needs to keep it up. I know, like I said, I know it's his first finals appearance, but that is not an excuse, and he needs to produce more. He needs to have a playmaking skill. He needs to be that sort of 3-and-D guy that we traded for earlier this year, along with the Iguodala trade. I need to see more from Jay Crowder, but if this is the chance that they're gonna trade him, or maybe he signs somewhere else, maybe that's a possibility. But who knows? Who knows? Now, to my last candidate, the one Heat player that I could possibly see leaving is the one and only Myers Leonard. Yeah, that guy. I mean, I like Myers Leonard. I've always supported his personality, you know, his little gameplay scenarios that when he's off the court. But as of late, you've all noticed that he has a less of a significant role than what he had earlier in the season. Now, when we came to the bubble, he hasn't been playing as much. You know, he's just been on the bench trying to, you know, root for his guys, cheer on, support them in their playmaking skills. You know, he was just kind of like the assistant coach of the team. And I felt that. I really did feel that. And honestly, that's kind of the reason why I could see him leaving. Because, you know, like I said, I know he was able to play in the finals, but that's only because he came in for Bam, who was injured. And sure, he looked fine, but it wasn't enough. I can sort of tell he was just kind of frustrated. He was just kind of off. He just wasn't that supporting big that we needed in the rebounding session. And I would hate to see Myers go, but I understand why they would do it. And plus, he's out there kind of complaining that he wants a bigger role if he comes back to the Heat, which, don't get me wrong, that's really appreciative of you, Myers, but do not turn this into Whiteside 2.0. Oh my gosh, why did I mention that Whiteside guy? Yo, you don't got shooters, Hassan. You don't got shooters. Let's go. Sorry, I don't mean any roasting, but again, Myers, love the guy to death. But he's got to do more. He's got to earn his minutes if he wants to talk about coming back for a minimal role. You got to earn it, Myers. You got to earn it. Otherwise, they're just going to trade you away. So overall, I think that would be it, because I don't see who else can possibly leave or who they might trade. Maybe there will be some surprises in the free agency. Maybe. Maybe they might choose the players that I predicted, or maybe they might surprise us and trade away, or other players that I didn't mention are going to go to another team. I really don't know, to be honest. And again, I mean no disrespect for any of these players, and I hope I'm wrong. I hope I am dead wrong about this. But I understand if Riley wants to move on from them. Totally understandable. I can fathom them to the fullest, because Riley is trying to build more and more. Sure, we've got to sort of phase one. Now we got to get to phase two and become stronger and go back to the finals next year. Or in the next season, which is like 2 months from now. But anything is possible. And I hope that some of the guys, or a couple of the guys, remain on the team. Heck, I'll even support if UD decides to come back for another year. I'm okay with that. I know a lot of people will complain, but I'm fine with that. I'm dead okay with that. So therefore, I think that's about it. Can't really think of anyone else. So good night. So I will see you in the next video. Peace out. And let's go Heat, everybody. Let's get back to the finals.